The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the dark...
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father. Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes.
Find another way to see the truth.
Funny. We all want to see behind the veil, don't we? But once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Seeing things differently. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
He's down! Finish! Strike him! winning.
Jazz!
Comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Druth.
Look how much has changed.
The Northmen say that Odin has two ravens. Their names are Thought and Memory, and each day he sends them out to fly all across the world. Upon their return, they perch on his shoulders and tell him everything they have seen and heard. In this way, he learns of things far and wide, and for this reason, he is called the Raven God. Senua, like Odin, you must seek wisdom through thought and memory if you are to succeed in your quest.
Fjallraven. Fjallraven's home. It's over here. It's over here.
Is that? It's over there. No, it's here.
There's two. Listen, focus. Listen.
It's magic. It's magic. It's magic.
This reminds her of something.
The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The wild. The wilds.
She left the wild. She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wild?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druce helped her.
She'd be dead. She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But it didn't work. She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. But she remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her. Thank you.
ravens.
They were one, no?
It's still three.
There's three.
There's three.
Where are they going?
Where are they going?
She didn't know.
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the globe. The smallest hints of shape, sound, or thought grew in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws. There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillian before her time comes?
Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keeping. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together. Speak to me, Druth. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth. Though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
gate is open.
It's open.
She didn't.
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.